Now, since leaving Westlife back in April, this next man has spent a lot of time back home in Dublin. He invited CD UK to visit some of his favourite haunts, including his old school. It's a very special report from Brian McFadden.
There's just something about Dublin, because it just captures you. And when you've lived here all your life, you know, nowhere else in the world compares to Dublin. Hi, CD UK. Well, this place behind me is very, very important to me. This is actually my first school, so this is where I got up to a lot of trouble.
I can't believe that's me. Every time I see that picture, I think that's not me.
I look like a monkey.
Not just a great pupil at school, but I used to cut my own hair.
We were in Mr. O'Brien's class, and he had to leave the classroom one day, and he told you, stay on your seat. And lo and behold, when he came back, there was absolute mayhem. And Brian was up with the seat over his head, the chair over his head. And you were able to say straight away, well, you told us not to leave our seat.
I never break the rules, but I love to bend them. Of all the places I've ever been, this is definitely the most important place in my life. This is where I grew up. This is my mum and dad's house. I'm very, very close to my mother. My mother's she's my darling. She looks after my babies as well for me, so. When I was in Westlife, it was hard. I didn't get to see mum or dad very much. Now I'm home and we definitely get to see each other much more, especially with my mum now, you know, helping look after the kids, so. And that there is Doe Castle, and that's the place where I proposed to Kerry.
The Westlife songs were not Brian, even though they were lovely songs and they sang them well, but the songs Brian is singing now are his own and they're actually Brian's.
Do you like them all?
No, there's one or two I don't like.
The Real to Me is about the things I hate about the music industry. Kind of record company executives having all these, you know, dinners with people that you don't really know and don't really want to know, and you have to kind of kiss their backsides to please other people. This is my football club, Beachcomber. We've been playing for 2-3 years now. But I'm standing outside the Point Depot now, which will be more than likely classed as the home of music in Dublin. For me, it definitely is. It's where I've seen my first ever concert. And of course, it's also now pretty much the home of Westlife. You see this sign here? It's basically talking about Westlife having the record amount of shows. The boys done 34 and I done 24 when I was in the band. My best memory of playing would definitely be in the Point, and it'd probably be the first time we ever played the Point on our own. It was our first, you know, hometown gig for Westlife. Robbie's the most successful solo artist of probably all time from the UK. I still would like to have his success, yes, it would be great. We were both in a boy band. We both left the boy band. We both worked with Guy Chambers and we're both men. Yeah, so I suppose we're pretty much twins, aren't we? I don't miss all the hard work and travelling around the world and being away with my family, but I definitely miss the four boys because we used to have a lot of fun together. We used to always hijack ice cream vans and stuff like that, and I do miss the fun we used to have. And I miss them as people, because I love them, they're great guys.